Hi, this is MC Shetty for a new episode of my 1.14 modding tutorials. And today we are going to refine this block so it works ideal. That means a few things. For example, this diamond pickaxe looks much nicer, but this isn't that nice. It's an ugly name. Also, if you try to harvest it, it drops nothing. This is an important change in compared to 1.12. I will explain why that is in a moment. Also, there's no recipe for it, so all these things we're going to add in this tutorial. So first, you already know we have the assets directory. What is new in 1.14 is that there is also a data directory now. And data is available on the server side. So assets are on the client side and data on the server side. It follows a similar structure, my tutorial. And let's make sure that when we harvest drop, that something actually drops. So for that, you need a loot table. And the easiest way to get started with that is to just look at the vanilla example. For example, an easy one like cobblestone.json. This one would work. That's very simple. Let's make a file. First block.json. Yes, copy it. One difference you should know is that Forge requires pools to have a name. I'll just name it pool 1. So basically, what does this do? It's a block loot table, that's a type. We have one possible role, one possible drop entry, and only one entry, which is Minecraft item. But this should be my tutorial. First block. So this is the item we want to drop, and we also want to survive explosion when it is dropped. So here you can specify that something should not supply survive an explosion. This new loot table system is pretty powerful. There's a lot you can do with it. So this is the basic. One thing to note though, very important, it is not optional. If you want your block to drop, you will have to use something like this. So let's try it out. Okay, I actually forgot. Oh, what did I do? Yeah, I forgot I need a directory. Blocks in between, so this should go one deeper. It wasn't actually working. So let's try it again now. Okay. Yeah, that's better. So, you see, yeah, now you have a good loot table. Okay. There's a lot you can do here. You can have different pools, drop multiple items. This is also, it is also possible, but I will show that in a future tutorial, once we work with tile entities, to save information from the tile entity and store it in the dropped item, so that when you put back the block, for example, you get everything back as it was. That's how, for example, the choker box from Vanilla is implemented. You can use it to make a chest that keeps its contents, or a machine that keeps its energy, and so on. So that's very useful and a very powerful system. So another thing we want to fix is to have a proper language file. That's something that goes into the resources, that's client-side. And this has also changed a bit. I will refer to my other mod. as an example, it's now JSON, like everything. This is the English one, and let's just block my tutorial first block. And that should be it. And we're also going to add a recipe for it. That's on the data side, because recipes have to be known server side. And we are going to take an example. For example, chest.json. We seem to be having a lot of files that are called firstblock.json. If that's confusing, you can of course add a suffix to them, for example firstblock.recip. I'm not sure you can do that here though. I know for this one it doesn't matter. You can have actually, it's probably okay for this one to have a different name, but this one must be named like this, because here it uses the actual registry name of the block. You can't rename that. However, you can rename the models. You can, by the way, also structure them in subdirectories by putting that here. And you can, of course, rename the textures as well. So that's possible. But let's make the recipe. Let's copy it from vanilla. So it's a regular shaped crafting recipe for our block. We will do something different. I want to use mostly cobblestone. So key, that means the X has to be item Minecraft cobblestone, and for in the middle I want something with a tag. Also, let me fix the result. My tutorial first block, and let's forge dice red. Hold on, let me check that that's correct. I've used that here as well. Yeah, forge dice blue. Yeah, this should work. Let's try it out. Something to keep in mind is that the OR dictionary that used to be in 1.12 is no more. Instead, Vanilla has its own system based on tags. It's a bit different, but it's also very usable. And this is how you use it in this example. So let's try to see if our recipe worked. First of all, let's see if the language... No, so we have a problem with our language file. I have to check that in a moment. So that isn't working. But let's give ourselves a crafting table. Crafting table. And let's see. Red die and cobblestone. Can I put, yeah, like that? And let's see if it works. The red die in the middle. Yeah, at least that is working. And now it's added here. It wasn't added before because that requires advancements, so that the recipe book knows about your block before, when you have the ingredients in your inventory. But at least it gets added as soon as you know the recipe or have crafted it once. But let's check what's wrong with the language file first. Okay, it's easy to see. I missed this. There's a trailing comma. So this should work. So it's working now. Our block is properly called first block, as it should be. And you also see it here. So our language file is correct, our recipe is correct, and our loot table is also correct. So this block, it's basically ready. What more do you need? It's finished. We're done. Okay, no, we're not done. We want to do a lot more. Let's first commit these language file and loot table. Okay, so we also want our own creative tab so that we can easily get our item. And I usually do that in a kind of, it's a matter of style, but I prefer a separate mod setup class containing public static void init and actually public void init doesn't have to be static and public static mod setup. Setup is new mod setup. Setup.init, like that. It's a matter of preferences. You can do it however you want. You can put it here directly. That's fine. What I also do for future is extend the proxy for specifying client-side and server-side initialization. We will use that in the future. I just add an init and implement in both, like that. And it's empty for now. So this init can be used if you want to set client-side initialization, that should only happen on the client, or server-side initialization. And I call that proxy directly after setup. So first I do the setup, then I do the proxy initialization. So this is currently all empty. It's there for future reference. So now in the setup, I'm going to create a private item group. Is new item group like that. Hold on. So let's put a name here. Let's call it my tutorial, simple as that. New item stack. Mod blocks.firstblock. This should be public actually. Let's make it static as well. So this is our item group. We don't have to actually initialize it here. It can just be done there. And then we can use that in our registration here. So in contrast with 1.12, you no longer can put blocks in Creative Tab. You can only do it on items. And let's put this in a variable. Properties, and then add .group setup. I prefer, let's make it non-static. Because I have an instance there, so I can just do it like this. Again, there may be better ways to do this, but let's just have it as this for now. In the language file, you also need something like that, so that it looks nice. comment creative tabs, item group my tutorial, my tutorial. Okay, let's try it out. So to test this, we need to go back to creative and yeah, there it is, tutorial before blocking it. So that's how you can create your own tabs. You can have multiple, of course. That's up to you. So it was fairly easy to do that. Just make sure you have a creative type item group, and when registering the items, you set the group. So you, this is an item properties. If that's there are multiple things you can set here, max tag size and so on. But if that's fine, then you can reuse the same properties for all your items. That's okay. Okay, so let's commit all this proxy and item group. And let's close everything. So now I want to add my first item, similar system. Let's call it, you name it, first item. Note that for items you often don't actually need to make a class, you can just instantiate item directly, but maybe we want special functionalities here, so that's why I do it this way. For some weird reason, so both item and block use a properties object as a parameter, but the way they are created is different, and that's a bit weird, but okay. So for blocks you have to do properties.create, which is a nice way to do it, I think. For item properties you actually have to create new item.properties. I don't know why they decided to do it like that. Like that. Let's set some other properties, maximum stack size. No, let's use one because there should be something. Yeah, the rest is okay. Set registry name, first item. Just making the basic stuff first. Object holder, my tutorial first item. Public static first item. First item, actually. Yeah. Okay, so that's fine. I need to register it in the item registry. Event.get registry. Put register new first item. Because first item, that's a matter of preference as well. You could pass in the group, the properties, and set a registry name from here, but I usually decide, prefer to do it directly in the item constructor. It's up to you what you like. There, both ways are possible. So this should be it. That's the first item. Let's also make a model. And let's make a model that looks a bit like the vanilla, for example, pickaxe. Diamond pickaxe. So like that. Sorry. So new file first item.json. Yes. So this can be the same item, my tutorial item, first item, new directory item. I just copy that for now. And hold on, diamond pickaxe png. Let's copy this. That looks copy And normally, hold on. Okay, there it is. To a new layer, let's remove this, merge down, and let's make it, let's just change the color. Purple, that's good. Okay. Let's add our language entry. And while we're at it, let's add a recipe as well. And let's do it like this. For this one, we will use my tutorial first block. First item. Let's try it out. Okay, so it's working. This is our first item. It looks like a pickaxe, but it's not a pickaxe actually. It just works because you can break everything. But it should have a crafting recipe. Stick. And let's pick a few more of these. Game mode survival. And let's see if we can make our... Yeah. So it works as well. Maximum stack size should be 1. Yeah, you can. You cannot put them on each other. So it's working. Okay, so time our first item. So this concludes the second episode of this tutorial. Just going through all the basics. Next episode we will probably start adding some functionality to these things and maybe work on our first tile entity. So see you next time. Bye bye.